Good afternoon, Southwest Florida. I'm Bri Walling. This Naples Herald Lunch Break is sponsored by our friends at Fusillo Kia of Cape Coral. This afternoon, we'll tell you about bullied Florida students receiving vouchers for school choice, a plan to increase affordable housing around City of Palms, and more. Today is Thursday, November 9th, and this is the Lunch Break. Florida House members are moving forward with a controversial proposal that would allow public school students to receive voucher-like scholarships to attend private schools if they have been bullied, harassed, or subject to violence. The HB 1 bill, also dubbed the Hope Scholarship Program, is a priority of House Speaker Richard Corcoran, a major supporter of school choice programs. But critics questioned whether it's more about expanding the voucher program than it is about empowering the students. Some also said lawmakers should instead focus on dealing with the students who bully others. The private school aid in the Hope Scholarship Program would be funded through tax credits on the purchases of new or used cars. Car buyers would be able to designate $20 toward profit organizations that would administer the scholarship program. And in return, car buyers would get a $20 credit on the taxes they would otherwise pay on the purchase. But Representative Joseph Abruzzo said the proposal of using tax credits on vehicle purchases to fund scholarships would be the step towards using other similar strategies to expand the vouchers. Read more about the program online. Southwest Florida leaders are struggling with how to attract lower-priced housing into their jurisdictions as residents struggle with figuring out how to pay the bills. Affordable housing discussions have been commonplace in city and county boardrooms, with talk on how to create and promote developer incentives to build housing within the price range of teachers, nurses, and first responders, all vital to the community. In Fort Myers, one newly elected council member has an idea, and it centers around the City of Palms Park, the former spring training home of the Boston Red Sox. The land's only current tenants are FSW's baseball and softball teams, leaving open several acres of parking space once needed for thousands of baseball fans. Fred Burson, the newest member of the Fort Myers City Council, has the idea to turn that unused parking space into housing. The plan would see the property being pre-approved for higher density residential and commercial usage before selling it to a willing developer. The move is meant to generate revenue both from the sale of the property and the new tax base it would create, while also providing a source of affordable housing that would hopefully spur further growth. A military jury begins deliberating today on whether a Marine Corps drill instructor is guilty of beating, stomping, and choking new recruits, or whether accounts of his abuse towards Muslim American recruits were overhyped by young troops. Gunnery Sergeant Joseph Felix was allegedly at the center of an abusive group of drill instructors at the Parris Island, South Carolina boot camp. Felix was charged after the Marines investigated what drove one of his Muslim trainees at the boot camp to commit suicide in March of 2016. Investigators found unchecked abuse of recruits by junior drill instructors at the training depot, and Felix is accused of mistreating three Muslim recruits, including one that committed suicide in 2016 by jumping off a stairwell after an encounter with Felix. Felix is accused of obstructing justice for telling recruits not to cooperate with investigators after the suicide. He's also charged with drunk and disorderly conduct and making false statements. He pleaded not guilty. Read more online. And that was the Lunch Break for today. I'm Bri Walling. The Lunch Break airs Monday through Friday at 12 p.m. right here at NaplesHerald.com. And don't forget to check out our morning report that also airs Monday through Friday at 8 a.m. Thank you for watching. We'll see you tomorrow.